Okay, I'm back with a follow-up reading, and these were the cards that we had yesterday about love. And it is about going from a mystery to offering somebody a type of expansion, to showing maximum clarity to somebody who is quite difficult. This is maximum clarity, intellectual growth. And here we see the cups, and the cups, the three of cups is a card that you know you are really into getting things done and achieving goals, but also about never being satisfied, always hungry, always looking for more, always not trying to just get the best, but more of that. So I think a very earthy person like this needs the ambition, the clarity, the sharing of ideas, connecting, but doesn't understand the emotional drive behind. These are two very emotional drive. I think you are very passionate, very passionate person, but never satisfied and always hungry, always looking for more, always looking for challenges, always looking for, let's think about this. This is about good luck that doesn't seem to fulfill you. A greed for possession and pleasures, and that's something you and the other person have in common, but you, it's more, here it's more on a practical level, and here it's on an emotional level where you fight for something, where this person is more guarding, protecting, fighting against negative energy flowing in, not wanting to risk anything, playing it safe. So if I look at these cards in more depth, let's take this deck. I'm going to place these here so I can go back to them, but they are not in any way bothering me. So a full deck, I think that's... So if you are about, and I can be totally wrong here, but there's something about you that is mysterious, is about not opening up. It's about using the clouds to create this veil where part of your life is unseen and protected. It's very emotional, very watery. Let's see if I can give you some information about you. Here we go. And this is the Six of Cups. That is old memories. It's also sexuality, it's lust, it's a sexual desire and a passion for life that's rooted in a history, a long line of history. So you are interested in the practical side of a relationship, interested in the practical side of a relationship, and not afraid of a little bit of luxury, but you also want to, you are tempted to... Here we have something, we have something similar going on. I have to grab these again. Passion, desire, forever hungry, forever driven by emotions, deep-rooted emotions that are born in the past, that were born in the past. This is making things worse, to be honest. I think this is making things worse instead of better. So let's see. Let's put it this way. These are a match. These three are a match. It's about mystery. It's about sexuality. It's about deep-rooted passions. It's about emotional fulfillment and almost an addictive attitude to emotional satisfaction, emotional drive. But it balances things out with, I think this is your ex, and her wanting to focus mostly on the material, the potential, the practical potential of a relationship where there is something earthy, earthbound to build upon. And for you, this is the disconnect, because you are able to clear things up, to move away the clouds, to chase away the clouds, to make sure that the dog and the wolf come to a certain agreement. But this is sort of weighing you down. Old emotions, old pain, old experiences. And if you can relax a little bit, clear things up for yourself, you can clear things up for yourself, and then you can clear things up for other people. Let's say this is a bad habit. Not being open, always being secretive, always hiding, working on, you know, sometimes it's smart to hide plans before they come into fruition. And sometimes it's smart to share them with others. But you have to be very picky about who you choose to share things with. So if these are two dogs, that says something about loyalty, about connection, about following somebody else to the death. But if this is a dog and a wolf, you need to lure them in with emotion and temptation. But at some point you are, you know, forced to look at the ghosts from the past and clear things up so you can get on the same track. I think that makes things a little bit more precise, I think. So here we have you, driven by old fears, driven by old emotions, driven by maybe trauma, bad experiences. Everybody has bad experiences, but it's a combination between bad experiences and lust, and an unhealthy balance between the way you express yourself emotionally and physically on a sexual level. So there is something going on that might even be cruel or hungry, or, you know, it's like if you're always driven by old emotions, the chances that you are disappointed in everyday now real life are almost 100%. So nobody can give you what you want. Not as for addictions, not for deep desires, not for fantasies, not for any type of satisfaction. And, you know, you can start focusing on a new opportunity that is more practical. I think practical is a there's something egocentric about the whole thing. Do you know what I mean? It's I don't know you. We haven't shared much, but if you are only going for it's true spirituality isn't about addiction. True spiritual life isn't about basing the now on old memories. True spirituality isn't about all material things. So there is something unhealthy or undesirable about the way you go about love right now. So let's see if I can look into... By the way, this is fun. This is sweet, this is innocent, this is fun. So it's not all bad. And this is, you know, cool and crazy and intense. And this is explosive. And it's not all bad. But if it's drawn into the moon sphere, then it becomes something that's difficult to deal with for a lot of people. So you need somebody very, very strong that is able to, you know... look through the surface and help you maybe clear things out and be more productive. So as for family, let's look into family. This is the family card. So we are, I think family wise, you're not in a bad spot. You're not in a bad place. There's the dog. It's... success and well-being, and you are able to share with others. There's a positive outcome, so you are having this connection with friends and family. There is somebody very interested in you who is ready to follow you wherever you go and in whatever you want to do, but you have to look her in the eye. She is mature. She is also a little bit confused about who you are. This is in friends and family. A little bit confused about who you are. There's a lot of love. There's a lot of loyalty. But this is a demanding woman that likes to drink. This is kind of a match, by the way. Because the Queen of Wands is interested in magic, in dreams, in fantasies, in escaping the real world. And the way you are in love right now, this is a... So there is something good in the family and friends situation. But I was interested in this woman. So we are going to pull one card. And... I think she is ready to start a new life and be creative and productive. And there's a very materialistic side to her that doesn't understand the depth of emotions. It's like she is more a motherly type of person that can be overprotective and jealous and... too controlling, especially on the part of housing, cars, shopping. A woman that is into something luxurious. So we have that one. And I can be completely wrong, but for some odd reason, these cards are so specific. It's not like I'm trying to move into a more, maybe you've noticed, into a more spiritual realm with the cards. But it's sort of dragging me into a very specific type of things going on in your life. And this, I have to be honest, this doesn't happen very often. So if this is something that you're not interested in, you always have a choice in life. As for law, we have the Queen of Pentacles again. By the way, this is the same card. So, just so you know. So, this is more the family, friends type of section. This is about her being And she's looking for an emperor, somebody who can control her, somebody. That's where the devil comes in. There's a woman, if this is not your ex, there is a woman that's very materialistic, very creative, very in touch with nature, is very strong-willed, is very practical, very down to earth. And she's looking for an emperor to help her out, achieve her goals. So that's something that lies in the futures, but it can also be born in the past. So that's the weird thing about these cards. You've got confusion in the friends and in your friends and family departments. You have clarity in the ex-ex's relationship, but this is also future. So if this is not your ex, there is a woman waiting for you that wants you to take charge, and but you have to be practical with her. If you drive her insane with sexuality, sensuality, mystery, craziness, addictions, and unhealthy behavior, then the results aren't that maximum or optimal. So things you cannot change about the whole situation. Things you can't change. And this is more, you know, to think about. And I am so... These are the things that you cannot do something about. Being attracted to more than one woman. Being attracted to women in general. And wanting to celebrate. And why do we have the Three of Chalices again? Because this is the same card. This is a little bit, you know, about you being mysterious and attractive and make others crave for you. Where you are the King of Wands, you can team up with somebody in your surroundings, family, friends, as the King of Wands. And there is betrayal and cruelty. So this is something that you cannot... These are the things that you cannot escape. This is something that's part of you, or you love women or whatever you're interested in. The deep desire to share. But there is a polarity in you that wants to keep things secret and has to keep things secret and to open up. And they, I think then it leads to the devil card, where things become unhealthy because you cannot be lying and truthful at the same time. So that's what breaks you up, I think, a little bit. This is again the betrayal and gossip that we talked about. So if there is somebody talking about your back, it's a man. That's for certain, an older man. Somebody is older than you. So that's something that you cannot change. You cannot do something about. And then we go to the things that you can do something about. These three. The ultimate judgment is, I think, in your favor. Life can be a little bit, you know, foggy even for you. Life is full of mysteries. And I think these, you know, this is just amazing, actually. You know, even though there is confusion, there's mystery, light's coming in. And you've got judgment and the world next to each other. So in the old Florentine sequence, there was, you know, moon, star, sun, and world. And this would be the ultimate completion of bringing things into the world, being of this world, not trying to escape it, but full fulfillment. And then judgment came, where, you know, there's ultimate freedom. So what you... I shouldn't do something about this, by the way. Not at all. In whatever order. The Florentine tradition or the Rider-Waite-Smith tradition. Where world where judgment becomes before world instead of world before judgment, because you will be judged in a great way. So I think with these great cards, where you can do something, I don't think you have to do something about this. It will just, you know, if you create clarity, if you create honesty, if you heal from all trauma, then these will automatically be yours. But you have to stop nibbling and nitpicking on minor things, focus on the big things, dive into your emotion, clear things up, and if you are able to really sincerely share with others, even if you are confused and you don't know what you are confused about, just express your emotions and express them, not put them in a cellar or in the attic. You know, just place your doubts and confusions and stresses and whatever in right in front of you so you can look at them. I think you will be well on your way. But mystery is a mystery, and I still see a lot of mystery here. I just can't get a full grip on, because these cards are so, these are so the same and so contrary, opposites. You know, this is more mature sexuality, this is more an innocent sexuality. So these go together in your, you are like, you know, you are this and you're that. You bring opposites together. And in the middle somewhere is what causes the confusion. Because if you can be the devil and a child, then that's almost art, spiritual art. So there is a man in your life that is trying to beat you up or frustrate you or take your innocence away, and he only looks at the negative of you. So there is an older man that is talking behind your back. These are the options that you have. And I would focus on family and friends for a while and deal with things, also because the old memories are attached to or connected with. Old memories are more attached to the family than to a future love life. But this lies ahead, I think. I hope this makes sense. And if not, I did my best. So, see you next time. Bye.